This is Future Talk.
Future Talk.
Future Talk with Omnia Al Saleh and Hani Balkis.
Happy Tuesday, everyone, and welcome back to Future Talk right here on Pulse 95. This is the one and only place where we give you a quick roundup of everything that is happening in the tech world, in the UAE, and all around the world. Today is a very exciting day because we're basically one day away from the well-awaited long weekend, especially because we are celebrating a new year in the Islamic calendar, and we're excited for it. But coming up right here on the show, we have lots of interesting news happening right here in Sharjah as we discuss the Sharjah Airport Authority enhancing its self-check-in services. Do you like self-check-in?
I've never done it.
Really?
Yes. Never done self-check-in. Always would go to the desk directly. And I forgot actually. I haven't traveled in a while.
It's been long.
Yeah, it's been a long time since I got on an airplane, I think back in 2018. But I do believe I never went on
self-check-in.
Self-check. But, you need to check yourself if you got 2G, though, because the 2G mobile network in the UAE is going to shut down in December of 2022. So you got about a year and a couple of months left. And, you know, 2G, when it came out, I keep saying 2J, because 2J is a car motor or a turbo that I've been reading about lately.
My God.
And it keeps getting stuck in my brain. It's like the Jeffrey Bezos song.
What?
Jeffrey Bezos,
how
born in 1964.
How come I haven't heard that?
You're not on TikTok. But again, the mobile network in the UAE will be shut down, which is that does support 2G.
Again.
Right? It's stuck in my mind. We do know it was a breakthrough technology when 2G was announced. And unfortunately, we're all the way at 5G now. And soon enough, we'll be at 6G. So we don't need the 2s anymore.
It feels like it's so long ago that 2G was a part of our lives.
Maybe 10 years ago,
yeah.
12 years ago. I think it's going to be around 13 years ago because BlackBerry had the 3G technology.
So 2G is even older than that. Well, we're also going to be talking all about weird tech and Hani's favorite topic of tech, which is deepfake technology, because the deepfake technology where Tom Cruise was actually mimicked, that guy who did it, even though he came out and apologized, he decided to turn this whole technology into a very real AI company. And we're going to be telling you exactly how it was born.
Yes, and we're also talking about sweatproof electronics and how Smart Skin has taken reliable vitals even during workouts. Now, we do know that wearables are the next thing coming up. And a lot of people, they're looking at smart watches, smart t-shirts, smart glasses. But now we're going to be talking about Smart Skin.
Yes, indeed. And today is all about, talking about the good old things back in the day. And the Paint app is one of the good old apps that a lot of people loved whenever they used the Microsoft operating system. And today we're going to be talking about how they're giving that app a little bit of a makeover. Sometimes it takes me a second to realize that people still use these apps. Some little kids are still interested in the Paint app. So we're going to be telling you all about that fresh update and lots more in just a few moments.
So keep Pulse 95 locked because we're going to be right back and we're going to leave you with a song called Cold. I actually wish it was cold, but it's not cold. But, why not listen to cold songs?
And think as if it's cold.
And listen to Coldplay. But this is Maroon 5 Cold.
Daily digital news. Bits and bytes connect our world.
Checking into Terminal 3. Please get your passports. The flight will be flying in about T-minus 10 minutes. So if you haven't gotten your check-in yet, your passport, your boarding pass, please do so as of now.
Believe it or not, when I actually was at the airport, one of the people who was calling for one of the flights sounded exactly like you.
Or I do a great impression.
I don't know. He just sounded exactly like you. So
I don't think so. I think I just do a great impression.
You do a great impression.
What kind of accent was it?
I don't know. It was just like he was calling. He was like, last call for the Doha flight.
Right.
Flight to Doha.
Last call for the Doha flight. We got flying at an altitude of 1,489 meters.
Why did he talk like this? Like, it's so like, like they're tired of life.
And they're underground.
Yeah.
Basically.
Yeah. Wow. But listen, ladies and gentlemen, if you're at the airport and you get a call like that, you're like, oh man, I gotta check in, I gotta wait in the queue. Well, no longer you do have to wait in big, long queues because the Sharjah Airport Authority has enhanced its self-check-in services. Now, that service is currently available for passengers with Air Arabia through self-contained kiosks located in the departures hall.
Yes, indeed. And this is going to help make us travel to all destinations very easily and also very safely. So this is actually part of the smart transformation that the Sharjah Airport Authority is planning for all of us fellow travelers this summer. It's going to help you self-check-in, but also do a self-baggage claim system. And I think one of the best perks of traveling at any airport right here in the UAE is being able to, I think that's only with the, no, even when you travel, when you go in and you, instead of, to me, I don't do self-check-in, but I check in my bags into the airplane and then I go through the e-gate system, which I think is just so convenient because you put in your Emirates ID yes, and you're in. You don't have to stand in line, you don't have to give your passport, and the self-check-in is kind of a very similar way because you just get to check in your bags, especially if you know yourself, you're not going to be overweight when it comes to bags, you're good to go. There's no waiting in line.
You know, self-check-in, I do believe, again, it's very convenient, right? And with these new initiatives, the Sharjah Airport Authority does aim to increase their customers' satisfaction and to improve their experience at Sharjah's premier gateway, which will enable them to reach their destinations around the world very much easily and safely. So again, this initiative was done for the passengers and customer service of, you know, because again, the number one thing that a lot of people look at when they're going to a restaurant, to any type of business service or any type of service that is provided to you, customer service is number one thing.
True.
You know, and you know, Omnia, as I grow older, you know, I start to care about these things. I don't know why, right? Like, if someone's giving me an attitude,
because you're adulting.
Man, it sucks sometimes because, you know, like, I don't remember what happened, but I remember someone was giving me attitude. I think it was at the bank.
Yeah.
Right? And I was like, hey, like,
I'm
like,
the customer.
Like, I was going to be a Karen for a second, right? I was like, I was getting really, really annoyed and aggravated. I'm like, calm down, Annie. You're still young.
Take a deep breath.
Take a deep breath. Right? Just calm down. Because she was like, just go and do this one. I'm like, what do you mean just go and do that?
I'm coming here for help.
And also, 2 days ago, I was at the pharmacy.
Yeah.
Right? I got an x-ray and then they gave me things and I had to go to the pharmacy to get some medications. And, you know, there was a long queue. No problem. My number comes up. I give her my number, the number for the queue. And she looks at me. She's like, sit down. I'm like, what? Excuse me? And she's like, sit down. I'm like, what do you mean sit down? Like, I'm waiting in line. What do you
say? Okay.
She's like, it's going to take some time. I'm like, you know, there's a better way to tell me to sit down. Yeah. Like, please have a seat. You know, like, she's like,
just
okay.
Just give me a moment.
Yeah. She's like, okay, right? So, you know, like, I was patient, right? Like, yeah. 5 minutes, 10 minutes go by, and I still didn't get my medication. So, you know, I'm getting a little pretty annoyed.
Yeah.
So I stand up and I go through. I'm like, excuse me for 1 second. I'm like, first of all, customer service sucks, right? And second of all, it doesn't take that long to get me a prescription instead of you being on your smartphone, because she was on her phone the whole time. She's like, I'm doing things related to my work. I'm like, well, that's not related to your work because I still haven't got my medications
exactly
yet. And that's probably why there's a long line, right? I kid you not, 20 seconds later, she has my medication, right?
My God, so, I hate, you know, when people do that sometimes.
Yeah, I mean, again, and this is just a pharmacy, you know, and you know, Sharjah and Sharjah Airport Authority in general, they care very much about your experience, especially when you're going and coming from, because they know it's very, you know, nerve-wracking.
True.
For some people and a lot of people to be going onto an airplane.
Especially in COVID. I mean, during COVID, you don't want to be waiting in long lines because it just feels like an increased risk for you catching corona. And if you're wondering what is going to be happening at those self-contained kiosks, first off, you'll get to check in your bags. You'll get to get your boarding pass, which is very important for you to be able to board the plane. You'll drop your bags and then you'll move directly to the airport's passport control system, where a number of employees are more than ready to help you and give you all the assistance you need, even if you have any technical problems at those self-kiosks. And that's another thing that I love right here in the UAE. If you want to try out any technology, you're not like afraid that what's going to happen if it doesn't work out, you know? with other countries, they may introduce new technology, but at the same time, there's no one around to help you. So what if you put in your information and then you don't get a boarding pass, let's say?
That's a very good point, Domine. And I'm glad you spoke about it because, again, we do know that the UAE relies a lot on tourism, right?
True.
And again, you need to have the best services to be capable to handle this much load. I mean, we do know that the airports right here in the UAE, they're on the top of the list of traffic, either if it's transit or coming to the country alone. And the UAE has not been shy about providing the best services. And, you know, I've traveled a bit in my life, and I don't think I ever faced a problem leaving the airports here or coming to the airports here. It's always in other countries.
Yes.
I remember I dropped down to Fort Lauderdale back in 2018, right? And, you know, I was like, what is this place, man?
Where are the UAE's airports?
Right? There's technology was zero to none, right? Customer service was zero to none. Everyone was on top of each other. You had to look for signs. I was like, alhamdulillah, right here in the UAE, they have provided the best services, whether, it's at the airport, it's at a government sector. Everything has been provided to accommodate the residents and citizens right here in the UAE.
Absolutely. No matter where you go, even if you enjoy your time at any other country, you'll always feel homesick to come back right here in the UAE. Let me know, what was your experience at any of the UAE airports? Have you been loving the self-check-in and self-checkout kiosks? And yeah, let me know your experience with using tech at airports. Our text lines are open, 4215 Durat Salat, or sign into our DMs at Pulse95 Radio. Coming up, we're talking all about saying goodbye to one of the good old cellular networks.
Our old friends.
Yes.
This was back when the iPhone 2 came out.
Wait, I don't even remember what the iPhone 2 looked like.
Oh, sure.
Daily digital news. Bits and bytes connect our world.
Hey, you doing today, Omni? Yeah.
That is basically the noise.
Bad connection.
Yeah, that's what you hear when you would call, when you do a video call back in the day when 2G was alive.
So naturally, when that happens, Omnia, they start yelling, right? As if, you know, it's got to get better. I'm sorry, guys, if you're like, honey, calm down. I know my voice is loud.
That's so true, especially with parents.
Like, I can't hear you. What are you talking? What are you saying?
As if it's not a bad connection.
It's horrible, right?
The
it's
volume
like,
gets louder. The connection is it gets worse.
It's like, Baba, listen, right? I know you love them, but it's the connection. It's not your voice. Your voice is loud and clear, right? The neighbors can hear the problems you guys are having, right?
The neighbors can always hear international calls. I can just assure you that. Whether it's good connection or bad connection, for some reason, if it's an international call, the volume gets higher.
You know, Omnia, I'm victim, right, to
of
this.
Doing that?
I'm the culprit, right? So I'll be video calling people and my family members, right? I don't know why. I think it's an Arab thing, right? You just have to yell and scream.
Especially if it's like, if it's family.
Right?
The voice always gets louder.
I don't know why. It's like...
They can hear you, but still.
It's kind of disappointing. Like, I'm disappointed in myself because I'm reaching that age where I'm becoming like an old man.
I think it's just a habit. You know, you see your parents doing it, so you just copy them without necessarily thinking why you're doing it. But
yes, hella, kifik, you know, and you kind of become a little bit, you know, hesitant to continue speaking. You know. But again, I mean, today we're talking about, ladies and gentlemen, how the UAE is going to shut down the 2G mobile networks right here in the UAE.
The 2G era.
And that's where this joke all comes from, because we do know that, 2G was kind of slow, really
slow
back in the day. And if you were voice video calling anyone, that's how it would sound. And then you would have like, it wouldn't be that bad.
It would be good for a couple of moments.
Yeah, so everything's
and then
going
bad.
Like, now, and I miss you so much, honey, right? That's how it would be. And then you're like, I miss you too. You start yelling. But we have until December 2022. I don't know anyone who has a 2G phone, but, you know, if you got one.
A lot of people do. You'd be surprised. But a lot of people who have the good old Samsung, Nokia block phones, you know, those indestructible phones. Yeah, these have a lot of the 2G network, and any device that actually supports it will be stopped right here in the UAE market. So you can't even find a device that uses 2G anymore. in December of 2022. Now, the activation of 2G actually goes back all the way to 1994. At least right here in the UAE, it was introduced back in 1994. And it's actually still effective to date, believe it or not. Now, we've seen the networks kind of grow to reach 5G. And we even have countries who are currently experiencing and experimenting with 6G. And this is exactly why the UAE has decided to put 2G to rest and allow devices that use 3G, 4G, and 5G to only be alive in today's day and age.
You know, believe it or not, sometimes on 5G I get problems as well.
Same.
You know, I think it's just areas. And, you know, it's kind of, you know, disappointing. Because, you know, Blackberries were one of the first. And I do believe back in 2004, right, they introduced the ugly Blackberry. And then, oh my God, 2008, 2012.
That feels like a four-year period.
It's a decade ago, right? The BlackBerry Bold, you know, you were the hottest man on the market if you had that phone.
True.
Right? It was an aesthetic having a BlackBerry. And now we have these iPhone 12 Max Pros that, you know, slip in your hand. And by the
fall
way, ladies and gentlemen, if you guys are football fans, breaking news, right? We are a technological show.
Why are we talking about sports again?
Because Omnia Messi. Lionel Messi.
He left.
But he has just signed a 2-year deal with PSG, Paris Saint-Germain, right? This is ground.
Just right now. Wow.
And this is breaking. See, ladies and gentlemen, this is why you should always tune into Future Talk.
His steers broke the internet, and now
he's going to break the internet again.
Again.
Right? PSG, Omnia. You got Neymar.
Wow.
You got Ram. You got a lot of people, but again, don't want to derail. Yeah.
Why are we talking about sports again?
Any name sound familiar, Omnia?
Neymar.
You don't know Messi?
I know Messi.
Okay,
who doesn't know Messi? Come
Sergio
on.
Ramos.
No.
Okay.
No.
Let me think about...
My brother would be very disappointed
Mbappe.
Right now. No.
It's okay, Omnia. I'm fairly new in the football world. But ladies and gentlemen, again, 2G was, you know, that mark for, you know, the future. And now we're all the way at 5G. Mm-hmm. And it's kind of upsetting, believe it or not. I'll tell you why. Because we're looking at how at one point in time, we're going to have 6G, 7G, and then 5G is going to be, oh, you're on 5G?
What century are you living in?
Right? You get like 500 megabytes per second.
You see, the thing is, the only good thing about having those older cellular networks is the fact that they become cheaper. So the devices that you buy are actually cheaper in price. One phone that has 3G entry level will actually... No, it'll be at 126 dirhams.
To the dot.
To the dot. That's according to Ittisalat.
Okay,
that's what they sell it
by. I mean,
again,
but a lot of people, I don't think, will be inclined to buy 3G.
Yeah,
you know?
Unless your budget is too low, then it might be accessible.
Let us know your guys' thoughts. 4215 Duet Slot or on our Instagram at Pulse95 Radio. Do you have a historical souvenir phone that should be put in a museum, right, with that 2G Nokia phones? Taking a short break, but when we come back, what are we talking about, Omnia?
Deep fake technology and how one kind of joke turned into an entire AI company.
Check this out. Check this out. Pulse 95.
Deepfake technology, ladies and gentlemen. Omnia, how many times have you stumbled? You don't even use TikTok because you're old.
I do watch it,
You don't spend hours. Born in 1964, Jeffrey. Jeffrey Bay, you don't know that song.
I must say, all the TikTok videos I see are courtesy of Sama Matar. That's
it. Sama's very active
on TikTok.
But she never likes my TikToks.
Well,
she's tuning in right now.
You didn't get on the good list.
She follows me and I follow her. She doesn't like my TikToks, right? I'm expecting after
you track.
Of course I track. I care about who likes my stuff. You know, but again, on TikTok, you know, there has been kind of a trend with deepfakes, right? They deepfaked, Brad Pitt recently, or Cristiano Ronaldo. And one of the things that kind of broke the internet was the deepfake of Tom Cruise on TikTok. But, you know, believe it or not, the deepfake was so good. And a lot of people were fooled that now this man who deepfaked Tom Cruise has turned it into an AI company, has created an AI company because of his deepfake.
Yes, indeed. He was actually just goofing around when he created a deepfake of Tom Cruise. He was trying to show off his tricks and all that he's capable of doing. But now it has actually turned into a full-on company. Now, the deepfake of Tom Cruise was actually so popular that it got about tens of millions of views on TikTok, and it actually inspired him to team up with a lot of other deepfake, you can call them, enthusiasts.
And then they're going to master the ultimate deepfake.
Basically, they're creating a company that is going to be called Metaphysic in June. So, or they created it in June, and it's going to be launched very soon with full-on deepfake technology. Now, it's going to be using the same deepfake technology to make impossible ads and restore old films. So, you know, the good old films that we used to see back in the day, the black and whites, they want to kind of reenact those and bring them to life. They've also had a lot of clients, one of them being Gillette Razors. They had a campaign with them. They recreated a young Deion Sanders along with his 1989...
Is it bad I don't know these people?
No. Along with his 1989 draft day look. And they also created a campaign for the Belgian Football Association. Oh. They've had a lot of clients.
Oh, what? My God. When you said Belgian, I thought about waffles. You know,
Belgian
waffles. Oh, my God. Anyways, so why are you laughing, Omnia?
Because
you don't
somehow,
like waffles.
I love waffles, but you somehow tie it all into food immediately.
Yeah, because I mean, you know, food is life. Food is life. Food is amazing. But, you know, there has been much attention on the potential for using deepfakes for, you know, a lot of purposes and for good reason as well. Now, the first known examples of deepfake videos were posted to back in Reddit all the way in 2017 and did feature celebrity faces being swapped with those of stars around the world.
Yes, indeed. And over
but
time...
You know why Omnia is laughing? Because
why?
I remember sending her one of these videos of these stars.
Really?
Yeah. And she's remembering because I remember... You know,
yeah, that deepfake was so funny.
Yeah,
it was so incredibly funny, and it's so crazy how well they reenact
them. Yeah, and now this type of technology is being used for good, better purposes now.
Much better purposes. But they're also including them with very interesting special effects that were never out there in the market before. The Metaphysic founders are actually envisioning deepfakes to do everything from making old entertainers appear, people that may have... died long ago, actors, actresses, they're coming back to life with the deepfake TikTok. Why are we laughing about this?
Because Mikaela Atej actually just sent me our deepfake video.
My goodness.
Remember? The one we were singing in?
Why?
What do you mean? He's tuning into the show. He's reminding us of our deepfakes.
That was the worst deepfake. Actually, it was pretty good. I can't lie. But
it was okay, you know. And Omnia, you know, deepfake technology is becoming more and more accessible to the public, obviously.
Very controversial, yes, but
with these apps, it shows that it's fake,
yeah,
right? Because you can't make it perfect.
True.
But you know, I'm excited for the near future, but it's kind of, you know kind of concerning how, you know, so many people have access to this technology.
You can't trust what you see anymore.
So what if, let's say, I have a time machine, right, and I take a picture. You know, I have a photograph of Abraham Lincoln, right? Or a video of Abraham Lincoln.
Yeah.
And I show the American public, my name is Abraham Lincoln. And that's Barack Obama. I'm bad. I don't know. How does Abraham Lincoln sound like?
I don't know.
You're right?
Let me check for you.
All right, I'm Barack Obama.
Right? We know that there was a
The first deepfake was on Barack Obama. You're right.
Yeah. What was the Mona Lisa, actually? They did a deepfake of the Mona Lisa.
They have a voice of the Mona Lisa.
They had her face move to, I don't know who was talking.
Where is she from, the Mona Lisa? Is she British?
Isn't she Italian?
I don't know. Expertise in technology, not no artsy fancy.
I think she is, Mona Lisa.
Italian?
Where is she?
But again, I mean, we're looking at deepfakes, you know, changing the game in lots and lots of ways. But again, we need to...
Oh, she's from Florence.
That's a country? Florence, Italy, Omnia.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah, but more specifically from Florence.
Well, yeah, that's like saying go...
Dubai and the UAE.
Yeah,
give me
the general. Yeah, okay.
I gotta be specific.
Italy. Give me an Italian accent, Omnia.
Pizzeria.
I knew you were going to say pizzeria, right?
Where's the pasta and the pizzeria and the...
Think of it like the Godfather, Omnia.
Oh my God,
you
honey.
Come to me.
Oh my God.
With...
That's like the villain voice of...
Because that's how it sounds, right? And you know, it's always like, and you come to me and you want me to spare your life.
Let's spare them. Let's spare all the listeners reenactment.
Right? Again, ladies and gentlemen, 4215, do it slots or on Instagram at Pulse95 Radio. What do you think about deepfakes changing the way we view videos online?
Yeah.
Do you guys believe that this could be used for malicious content only, or can there be a good purpose for it?
What good do you see in it?
Omnia, you're on a roll today, because I was just about to say, what? I don't feel like there's any good to come out of it.
True.
Probably funny videos.
And I think keeping our culture and heritage alive, maybe. So
maybe, you know, you can reenact, you know, historical figures.
And movies and shows and things that people might have forgotten.
Like the Mona Lisa.
Back to the Mona Lisa.
I feel like doing an accent today. I might give you guys the contra accent right after the show.
That one.
You like that
Please,
one.
Please, no.
Why?
Please, why? I beg you, no. Let's go back to Italian.
All right.
Yes.
But ladies and gentlemen, we're going to take a short break. 4215, do it a lot. Let us know your guys' thoughts.
Gadget of the day.
New tech you might want to play with.
Pulse 95. Why do you look so disgusted?
I don't.
Oh, I thought we left the Italian accent segment.
I want an accent. I mean, you know, I always want to be a voice actor. Mm-hmm. Like for like animations.
Oh, like Mikel Atiyah.
Right? Like like for, you know.
Which cartoon
TV shows,
character?
You know, it does, like to create my own cartoon character. Right? Like my, because you know, I watch a lot of Rick and Morty.
Mm-hmm.
Right?
You want their accent now?
No, not their accent. I want to be a voice actor. I feel like it's fun.
It is fun.
And you know, I saw The Rock do the, what was that movie called?
Which movie?
Maluma? That's the singer. Wait.
Maluma's the singer?
Yeah. No, there was a Hawaiian one he did. He was fat.
Which one?
I don't know. But anyways, I mean, I've always wanted to be a voice actor. So, you know, one step, two there. But, you know.
Is it The King?
It's not The King, Omnia.
The movie, The King.
I don't know. I don't know what it's called, but there was a song he made with it. But, you know, I do believe when you're voice acting and you're screaming and you're yelling, you kind of sweat a little bit.
I think when you work out, you sweat. When you do a lot of things, you sweat.
Yeah,
when,
like imagine, Omnia, you're in a hot studio.
Yeah. They're usually not hot.
How do you know?
We are in one. But they're freezing cold to make sure the equipment stays good.
I mean, it's just a microphone.
It's just a microphone.
For them. But for us, we got a lot of gadgets and technological. You guys know we got like 4 screens in here.
Honey sits like a pilot, and I'm the co-pilot.
This is your co-pilot speaking, honey. But today we're talking about sweat-proof electronics. Mm-hmm.
We're talking about smart skin. And I was taking a reliable vitals even during workouts. Now, we know a lot of people care about their heart rate, their blood pressure, when they're working out, because you know some advanced athletes track them to see how their progress is going over time. Mm-hmm. But what if we told you you don't need a smartwatch, you don't need a band, you don't need any of that? All you need is your skin.
Yes, and a little bit of a sticky patch, because this smart skin is basically like a sticky patch that you stick it on your skin, and it can monitor your health without peeling away, without malfunctioning, without you having to even replace it every now and then. Even if you're the type of person who tends to sweat a lot. Today we're talking about this patch that has artificial sweat ducts. So it's very similar to the pores that are found on your skin. But what's interesting about it is that it is very effective when it comes to tracking your vitals. So it will help track your body temperature, it will even track your heart rate, and even track the progression of your skin color. So you can even detect if you might have skin cancer, or you might develop skin cancer or any other conditions with it. It's very breathable, so it's not gonna feel too tight on your skin, and it kind of feels like second skin, but a wearable.
Now, you know, we're looking at how wearables and smart gadgets in general want to be more and more discreet.
Yeah.
Right? And by the way, fun fact, we're going to bring up football real quick. You know, football players, they always have a band around their chest to track
their heart rate.
You know, I never knew that. I was like, how do they know? They travel like 80 kilometers. Right? Like, how do they know? Like, is there a guy like with a speed camera?
They're not wearing any Apple Watches.
They're not wearing anything. You know, the heart rate as well. But, you know, I do believe that this could be used for various reasons, right? And I do believe one of them would be, obviously the number one reason would be sports and athletes.
Yeah.
And, you know, for, let's say, you know, recovery, you know, therapy. You know, like a lot of athletes go to therapy.
Mm-hmm.
And sometimes you don't want, because you're saying, oh, hey, it's just a watch, it's not heavy. But at some point in time, it does kind of make a difference.
If you're sweating
if you're sweating,
track as well.
You know, I mean, you're jumping up and down. Maybe the heart rate isn't consistent. But, you know, having a skin that is not, Omnia said, tight, but skin tight.
Yes.
Right? You don't feel it.
Also, it can track your hydration levels, which is very important for a lot of athletes, especially if you're a runner. You want to make sure you're getting your water in.
She's exhausted.
Also, it can actually track exactly how much UV exposure you're getting. So, especially for different athletes, you would want to use it to help protect you from a heat stroke.
Good for swimmers.
Oh, yes. Very good for swimmers because it's also water resistant.
Well, I mean, it is sweat proof. Now, the design does help the patch conform or, you know, kind of grab the human skin as it does stretch and bend. And this type of flexibility is paired with the material's ability, just like we said, to withstand sweat, and it does enable it to monitor a person's health over long periods of time. Now, this hasn't actually been possible with previous e-skin designs, and the results were actually published not too long ago, all the way in June 30th of 2021, and it's a big step forward of, you know, a long-lasting smart skin that may track daily vitals or the progression of skin cancer and other conditions. So, you know, slap it on your arm.
There you
right?
go.
And, you know, continue your day. But I do believe it has to be, you know, visible to the sun. Right?
Yeah.
It can't be like,
Transparent, you mean?
Not transparent. It can't be like under clothes.
Oh, yes. Because it's going to have to measure your
UV
exposure.
Your forehead.
Make everyone know you're wearing a smart skin.
Or like, I think like maybe on your hand.
I feel like your maybe your wrist.
No, because like, let's say you're walking,
measure
on
your pulse.
Right? You're walking.
Okay.
I'm taking into consideration the UV rays, right?
Yeah.
So a little bit hard, but when you have it like this, because your hands are already always to the side.
True.
Right?
Let us know where you would wear it.
Put it on my forehead.
4215.
I'm gonna be a cyclone. Cyborg. Can you imagine that? I'll be like a little patch on my head.
Oh my God.
Right? Why are you laughing? This is the future. I mean, this is future talk.
This is the future, but it's a technology that I'm sure can work even under clothes.
No, but for the UV rays.
Yeah, true.
Right? Like, it's shadowy.
Us know. Where would you wear?
4215, do it slots, or on Instagram at Pulse95 Radio.
Pulse95.
Apps all around.
What's worth a click and download?
Today, we're taking a trip down memory lane to talk about a well-beloved app, the app that used to maybe entertain me for hours and hours on end. Did you ever bond with your friends over the Paint app?
This was my favorite app back in school.
Same.
My program,
yes.
Right? You know?
Especially in computer class.
Computer class, yes.
I remember we used to, like, the teacher would be explaining about something, and I would just have the Paint app on.
The paint bucket, you know,
yes,
changing it.
Yes.
The eraser tool.
I was the worst at drawing, still am, but nonetheless, it was my favorite app back in school. Now, school days are just filled with Fortnite.
Fortnite?
Yeah, Fortnite.
You play Fortnite?
I don't play Fortnite. I'm saying kids nowadays.
Ah,
that's their memory of school.
I thought you played Fortnite. I'm like, what?
No.
We're going to go 1v1, right?
I used to play, what was it? Still my favorite.
Crash Bandicoot.
GTA.
GTA?
Yeah.
Which one?
Which was my favorite.
Back in 2001?
No. Like, I used to love stealing cars. Hitting people and taking their
so
cars.
So it's just like real life. But it's that you don't steal.
What do you
mean?
You
don't steal cars, you hit people on the street.
I don't hit people.
You hit the curb.
I'm very nice.
How many times have you hit the curb?
It's so interesting that you mentioned this because I just hit a curb like 2 days ago.
Yeah, because when I was coming to work, I saw your tires.
Are they that damaged?
The rims.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm so concerned.
Like, yeah.
Because I actually got them checked out because I was so worried about the car.
So what were you doing for you to hit the curb?
I went on a sidewalk.
Yes. Subhanallah.
A triangular one, just to be more exact.
Ladies and gentlemen, have caution when you're on the road with Omnia.
And my car is so small.
Yeah, I mean, that's even worse because how could you make a mistake handling the car?
I forgot that I parallel parked and that there was a sidewalk in front of me.
Barakallah, Fiki. But
yeah.
Today, Microsoft is revitalizing the Paint app for its new operating system and giving it a new look and a more accessible menu. Now, this type of new aesthetic was revealed when Microsoft actually quietly posed some images of the app on Unisplash, which is kind of like, you know, their kind of own personal blog.
Imagine the Paint app is actually 36 years old. I never thought it was this old. Now, what's interesting about it is that this new update for Paint is coming because Microsoft wants to bring this app back. Now, I'm not sure how often people are going to be using it, but I think it's a great way for you to kind of show your kids one day what the app once or looked like once.
Yeah.
Once upon a time.
I'm getting new news right now, Omnia.
What's the news?
Right? You know, a little birdie has just came on my shoulder and says, you one time killed a cat.
Why do we have to bring back old crimes?
How did you kill a cat, Omnia, when she was driving, just for clarification?
It was the night I turned 23.
And how did that happen, Omnia?
It was my first crime.
You got 4 minutes to explain.
After turning 23. I was going fast on the road in Mueleh.
Okay.
And
Cat had a suicide, wish.
Look, the car next to me slowed down to let the cat pass the road or cross the road, and then I was just speeding, and it hit. I heard her head.
Like 70 kilometers per hour fast.
80 kilometers.
80, right? It was like, and you're like changing gears, Omnia.
I think it's time for us to wrap up the show.
Ladies and gentlemen,
before I talk about more crimes that I've committed.
More, I think we'll do it tomorrow, Omnia.
Nope.
Right, for the new Hijri year, so you can go into the new year with your dhamir, relaxed. What is your conscious? Yes.
It was the only thing I've ever killed. Just to keep.
Little birdie says you killed a couple of pigeons too. 4215.
No.
Do it, Salat, or on Instagram at Pulse95 Radio. What was your favorite story of today? My favorite story was Omnia killing cats.
Oh my God.
We're going to see you guys tomorrow, same time, same place, only here on Pulse 95.
If you liked this episode of Future Talk, drop a like and subscribe.
Pulse 95.
Be sure to follow us on Instagram for all our daily updates and top stories.